CMD Boxing Reports, Ronell Higg reporting here, and I'm back at it for the Boxing Fanatics. So 2018 is finally here. It's a brand new year. Last year it was great for boxing. Hopefully this year 2018 will be even greater, and not just for boxing but for everyone, I hopes. Now let's get to some boxing here. Now I'm gonna start off with the welterweights, you know, since we have some welterweights returning from, you know, last year and the previous year, like 2016. And that's with Amir Khan and Danny Garcia, and we also has a newcomer to the division who will be making, you know, his fight here in 2018, and that's Terrence Bud Crawford. But let me start here with Amir Khan first. All right, now Amir Khan says that he is coming back to take over the division, but basically the same statement that Danny Garcia has said. Now anyway, with Amir Khan, I don't feel comfortable with him. It really don't sit right with me with him coming back to the welterweight division. If anything, I truly do believe that Amir Khan should come back as a junior middleweight. Okay, now there are other fights out there for him at junior middleweight. Okay, we have Erickson Lubin. You have now the new Saddam Ali. You has Liam Smith. You has Ishe Smith, you know, and plus Kell Brook. He's now fighting at junior middleweight as well, you know. So, you know, a lot of people also wanted to see Amir Khan versus Kell Brook. And I already know that Kell Brook has a fight already scheduled, but I don't believe that'll be the only fight for him at, you know, junior middleweight at, you know, for the year 2018. And that's really dependent on if he gets, you know, hurt. If he does not get hurt, put it like that. Because I believe if Kell Brooks get hurt in this fight again, I truly do believe that'll be a wrap. But, you know, let's just hope, you know, that's not the case. You know, hopefully his eyes will held up. You know, you understand? Because we all knows now that Kell Brook is very delicate, okay? I mean, dude got both of his eyes sockets broken, you know? So hopefully, you know, everything is well with the man. He gets to hang up or hang around a bit longer and, you know, continue his career at, you know, junior middleweight. Now, I understand that, you know, junior middleweight does have some pretty big boys there, like Jarrett Hurd, Aris Landy Laura, and Jamil Charlo. But for Jarrett Hurd and Charlo, Charlo is staying. But Jarrett Hurd was talking about fighting Daniel Jacobs, and he's also, you know, talking about fighting Aris Landy Laura as well. Now, I don't know how true it is. They said the fight is on, it's already made, or I really don't know yet. So I'm not going to put it out there like I do know. But if it is, hey, kudos to both of them. But yeah, Aris Landy Laura and Jarrett Hurd are both talking about fighting guys like Demetrius Andre, who's at middleweight. Daniel Jacobs, who's at middleweight. So most likely them two will be taking, you know, the four steps up. So the only real threat at, you know, junior middleweight for Amir Khan would be, like I said, Jamil Charlo. But to me, on the real, I truly do believe that Amir Khan had grew out of the welterweight division. You know what I mean? He's been off so long. And not only that, but, you know, I'm pretty sure he's way above the welterweight limit. You know, his walk around weight. I mean, he's probably walking around at somewhere probably like 180 or 190, you know. So it, like I said, it'll make sense if he, you know, really does return as a you know, junior middleweight. Okay, you know, there are some small guys there, so he can, you know, that he can take on, you know. It'll make some pretty good fights, especially between him and Saddam Ali. Okay, like let's just say if, you know, everything goes well with Kell Brook. Okay, so Amir Khan and Kell Brook, they can get it on. Whoever win that fight could face, you know, the new champion, Saddam Ali, at junior middleweight. All right. And, you know, push come to shove, he can take on Erickson Lubin, Amir Khan, that is. That'll make a great fight as well. But back with Saddam Ali, to me, it really doesn't matter who takes on Saddam Ali. It could be Amir Khan or Kell Brook. Either way, I think it'll make a very great fight. All right, it'll be very nice to see Amir Khan at junior middleweight taking on these guys. I mean, it'll be very interesting, you know. Now, moving on with this Terrence Bud Crawford, with him, all right, he'll be making his you know, I guess debut at welterweight. He'll be taking on Jeff Horn. Now, in that fight there, I don't know, that's kind of scary, because Jeff Horn is a natural big dude. You know, I mean, we all seen how Manny Pacquiao looked up against him. I mean, Manny Pacquiao was so small that he made Jeff Horn look like a junior middleweight himself, probably almost like a middleweight. All right, because see, Jeff Horn, he's naturally big. And I understand that, you know, Manny Pacquiao, he came all the way up, you know, from 108 pounds. And Terrence Crawford, I think he's just coming up from like 130. All right, so he's not really that small like Pacquiao, but still, you know, I'm pretty sure that the size for Jeff Horn will, you know, give Terrence Bud Crawford some trouble. All right, but I'm not picking on winners, not yet. You know, this is something I have to, you know, take time to think about, you know, before I say, okay, Terrence Bud Crawford will easily beat him, because right now I seriously don't see that happening. Now, with Danny Garcia, ain't got much to say. And with Keith Thurman, ain't got much to say either. You know, same old, same old. We might not get the fight that everyone wants to see with the Errol Spence and all that. But hey, we'll see what take place. Excuse me once again. Now, I want to move on with the middleweights. Okay, all right. Now, thing is, we have Jermall Charlo talking about he wants to face Gennady Golovkin. Now, for me, that fight is suicide for Jermall Charlo, because really, if you look at his resume, like, Jermall Charlo doesn't have anyone that is anywhere near a caliber fighter like Gennady Golovkin. Now, I could have seen, I mean, not seen, but I could see if he had taken on someone like a David Lemieux. Now, David Lemieux, he's pretty close to a Gennady Golovkin type caliber fighter, all right? But he hasn't, okay? He has no one on his resume that is anywhere near as dangerous as a Gennady Golovkin. To me, that's just straight suicide, all right? I mean, Jermall Charlo needs a few more fights before he takes on Gennady Golovkin. So, I mean, I really don't know why he's so, you know, so much in a rush for that fight. I mean, he could end up becoming damaged goods, you know, facing Gennady Golovkin so soon, all right? Now, if I was him, I'll just, hey, wait it out for a while. Now, I also understand that Daniel Jacobs, you know, he wants to fight Billy Joe Saunders. And he also wanted Billy Joe Saunders to meet him over here in Brooklyn, New York, all right? My goodness. Here we go with this crap again. You know, just because Billy Joe Saunders came to Canada to take on David Lemieux, Daniel Jacobs, you know, thinks it's fair that he'll come to Brooklyn, New York to take him on. But no, I don't see it that way. Like Billy Joe Saunders has said, what does Daniel Jacobs brings to the table, you know what I mean, to make me come all the way from the UK or, you know, Britain or whatever, to come and face him in Brooklyn, New York? You know, that makes sense, you know, to me. So if anything, Daniel Jacobs will be going over to the UK, you know, to face Billy Joe Saunders. And not only that, but Demetrius Andre, he also had called out Billy Joe Saunders right along with Gennady Golovkin. Now for me, the way I, you know, sees it going down, I truly do think that Daniel Jacobs and Demetrius Andre shall fight first. And whoever wins that fight will go on to take on Billy Joe Saunders or Gennady Golovkin. Most likely, I really don't think that Daniel Jacobs wants another piece of Gennady Golovkin. Maybe he do, but if he wins, you know, against Demetrius Andre, most likely he'll be going up against Billy Joe Saunders. So, you know, that's how, you know, I sees it. that's my take on this. CMD Boxing Report. Ronell Hibb reporting here. I'll catch you guys on the next one.